We're going to attack Ada's lab soon. Time to see how talented all of you are. Get ready.
Who's the most talented minion? Let's find out in Minions Got Talent! First up is Minion A. Next is Minion B. Lastly, we have Minion C.
Voting time. Cast your votes for the most talented minion now.
Huh? What's going on here? So you can't figure out the winner, huh? Oh, I see. You've collected data, but you haven't organized it. We need to make this data presentable before we can draw a conclusion from it. Wait, do you know how to organize and present data? We can find data all around us. But what is data? Data is any collection of information, like names, numbers, or images. Food items and their prices on a menu, the types of vehicles moving on a road, and even your attendance report at school are examples of data. And when teachers take your attendance to put together the attendance report, they are collecting data. This process of collecting information from various sources to gain insights on chosen topics is called data collection. However, this collected data can be overwhelming and hard to understand just by looking at it. To more easily make observations from the collected data, we can organize and visualize it by using charts and graphs. For instance, this is a bar graph that shows the number of different vegetables sold in a supermarket on a given day. From this graph, we can see that cabbages are more popular than the other vegetables. This supermarket also collects data about the people who visit it. This much data can be hard to understand at a glance. But by filtering the data to a couple of things at a time and displaying this filtered data visually, we can more easily see how data is grouped and make out patterns, such as the busiest hours of the day at the supermarket, or the hours in which different age groups are more likely to visit, or how much money each age group usually spends. Once these conclusions have been made, the supermarket may use this information to choose the best times to clean the store or restock certain items. Organizing and presenting data is more effective with graphs and charts. See if you can think of other examples in which you can visualize data. See, by organizing and grouping the vote data from the audience and representing it visually, we'll know who the winner is. Presenting the most talented... Wait a minute. Why are we having a talent show now?
Time to show how talented all of you are. Get ready.
What? This is not what he meant. Get ready for the mission. Now!
Oh, hey there. I'm measuring the daily performance of the minions with a line graph to see how well they are working. Here's a fun activity for you. Keep track of how many glasses of water you drink every day for a week. Then plot a bar graph of the data to see if you're drinking enough water.